In this video, we will be looking at the Gweike Cloud G2. This is a true 20-watt fiber laser engraver, great for engraving any kind of metal and plastic. Here, I have the version with electric lifting Z-axis and the larger lens with 150mm engraving area. The machine has a rakus laser source which sits in this separate box. It is connected to the laser head with optical fiber. The power supply is a high-quality and enormous Meanwell branded power supply brick. The laser head can be tilted, which is great if you were engraving some angled objects that otherwise wouldn't fit under the machine. On the back of the head, you will find all the connectors. They are used to interface the power module, computer, and rotary attachments. This version has electric focus adjustment, which is controlled with these two buttons. Electric focus adjustment is very convenient compared to manual operation. The machine has a removable base plate so you can engrave objects larger than the machine. It also comes with a cone bracket for handheld operation. You also get protective glasses and these very sturdy spacers if you need to raise the laser head higher when working with taller objects or a rotary system. And you also get a metal ruler which is used for focusing. The laser head and laser source can be turned on separately, which is great since you don't need to have the laser source cooling fans making noise all the time when preparing and previewing the engravings. I have opted for the machine with the electric lifting system, which is operated using two buttons on the side. The larger, 150mm lens that I have has a focus distance of 261mm. The machine is controlled by their proprietary G-Laser software, which is a modified version of CCAD. The software is intuitive to use, but has some limitations compared to Lightburn, which we will see later. But they seem to be working on making it Lightburn compatible. The Gweike Cloud G2 has a red light live preview which can trace the vectors or just frame the outside of the engravings with a square. It engraves very fast and with high precision. The result is perfect. You can also adjust the correct focus distance by watching when the two red dots align. This method is quicker and easier than using a ruler, but it is less accurate. Let's try to engrave a metal business card. I will engrave this picture of a dog. Since the card is black, I needed to invert the colors. I have increased the DPI a bit, and the power was set at 40%. The result was perfect. Maybe I could use a bit less power, but other than that, it came out amazing. I also tried to cut this aluminum business card. The first star was cut at 100mm per second and 10 passes at full power. For the second and third star, I used much slower speed, but the result was just as good as with the higher speed on the first try. All the stars were cut out cleanly. Next, I tried to engrave this very intricate Star Wars coin on some brass with a high speed of 1,000mm per second. It is mesmerizing to watch the immense speed of this machine. The engraving is perfect. Next, I set the vector shapes to fill and engrave it with slower speed, maximum power, and low frequency, which are the best settings for very deep engravings. The result seemed interesting, and I have let it run for a few more passes to remove more material. Lastly, I have set a cleaning pass with high speed, low power, and high frequency, which results in surface cleaning effect. The result is incredible, and it shows that you can produce many different results just by tweaking the settings. The engraving is very deep and permanent. The G-Laser software has a helping tool to help you set the correct combination of the speed and frequency parameters. This tool visualizes the pulses that this machine is producing, and you can clearly see when the frequency is too low for the set speed as the dots are too far apart, resulting in a non-continuous line being engraved. The amount of overlap has a big effect on the results. You can also use this machine for cleaning coins. Using high speed, low power, and high frequency, the laser only removes dirt and grime, leaving a shiny surface. The Gweike Cloud G2 can also be used for removing rust from small metal parts. First pass is done with higher power and low frequency, followed by a second cleaning pass with low power and high frequency. It leaves a perfectly clean surface. The Gweike Cloud G2 can mark all types of metals, and you can use it to mark your tools so they don't get mixed up with other people's stuff. The deepest engravings are made with slower speed and lower frequency, but they produce darker engravings. If you want brighter engravings, you first run the before mentioned settings, and then you can run a second cleaning pass with higher speed, lower power, and higher frequency. The cleaning pass does not remove material. It just removes the dirt and cleans the engravings. The result is much brighter if we compare it to the non-cleaned engraving we made earlier. The Gweike Cloud G2 also performs well on stone surfaces. It leaves a deep and detailed engraving that will last a long time. The G-Laser software has some limitations, though. When importing SVG vectors, it often imports them incorrectly. The same vectors are imported in other programs without issues. I suspect it has something to do with different versions of the file format. But the DXF and Adobe Illustrator files are imported correctly and work fine. I went to engrave my logo on black acrylic. The engraving was great. I tried again by tweaking the settings a bit. The only problem I noticed is the fact that it did not engrave the shapes in one go, and consequently, the surfaces are not evenly filled due to uneven melting of the material. I had to change the fill pattern to this one, and then it engraved it in one go, and the result was perfect. Engravings on black acrylic really pop out and are very durable. Gweike Cloud G2 also performs well at engraving on white plastic. Using high speed, very low power, and high frequency, it melts the surface and leaves a nice gray engraving which is very durable and looks great. The Gweike Cloud G2 can be also used for annealing stainless steel. You need to defocus the machine 2 to 3 millimeters and use a very slow speed and medium power. This process does not remove material from the surface, but it heats up the surface of the metal to a certain temperature where a durable oxide layer is formed on the surface. The result you get are pitch black and durable engravings. An important thing to note is that fiber lasers don't work on wood at all. Using full power at 1,000 millimeters per second, which usually produces deep engravings in metal, doesn't leave a single mark on wood. But when I reduced the speed a lot, the wood had just caught on fire. If you want to engrave on wood, then fiber laser is not for you. Lastly, I went to see how well the Gweike Cloud G2 performs at engraving very small details, and we will test this by engraving very small text at medium speed. I tried engraving it multiple times with different speeds and settings to see if it makes any difference. 1 millimeter text is still perfect, but smaller text has some artifacts which I think are related to software because they were pretty much consistent. If anyone has more information about this phenomena, please tell me in the comments. In conclusion, the Gweike Cloud G2 is one of the most affordable 20-watt fiber lasers. The machine is great for engraving metals and plastic with high speed and precision. The only downside is that it currently doesn't support light burn, as the current software is limiting the machine's full potential. However, this might change with future updates.